Myself, I am Ram Krishna. I am going to deal the subject antennas and wave propagation. Now today I am going to explain about antenna, what are the types of antennas we have, and what is the functionality of antenna, and how radiation will take place. So all those things I am explaining point wise. Now first of all, what is antenna? Now, so according to Webster's dictionary, antenna is a metallic device. So it may be a rod or wire. So it has a hilly shape. So it is used to radiate or receive the electromagnetic energy. So this is the major functionality of antenna. First of all, if the antenna or a metal, so antenna is nothing but any metallic device. So if you want to excite this kind of antenna or a rod, so we need to apply an electrical signal. So once we are applying electrical signal to the antenna with help of a cable, so that is nothing but a guided media. So cables are maybe a coaxial or copper or optical cables. So now here I am going to take the structure of an antenna. So this is an electrical signal which is applied to an antenna through a wire. So this is nothing but AC source. So this is my cables or wires. So from here to here, this is antenna structure. Now the major functionality of antenna is it converts electrical to electromagnetic signal. After the conversion, it is transmitted to the free space at the transmitting end. And also at the receiving end, it receives the electromagnetic signal and it converted into again electrical signal. So now, so this is the transmitting section. So now here we have a channel. This is the receiving end. So at the receiving end also we have a receiving antenna. So now we have a destination. Now the signal is transmitted with help of the transmitting antenna, it is received by the receiving antenna. Here we have an antenna, receiving antenna, from here to here. Again, we are giving this electromagnetic signal to the destination through cables or wires. Again, we received electrical signal. Okay, so this is about antenna. What is radiation? So as I said, the antenna is used to radiate the electromagnetic energy to the free space. It receives the electromagnetic energy by the receiving antenna. So that means the antenna has to convert the electrical signal to electromagnetic signal. So electromagnetic signal go to the free space. This process is named as radiation. Understand? Okay. So it converts electrical to electromagnetic signal. Electromagnetic signal fed into the free space. That mechanism or the process is named as radiation. So now how the radiation will take place in an antenna. So here, if you take a radiation mechanism, in an antenna. So we can take a radiation mechanism in an antenna in two cases. One is radiation mechanism in single wire antenna, radiation mechanism in two wire antenna. So now here I am going to explain about single wire antenna. So for example, here if you take this is a wire. This is my wire. Now I want to apply here analog source, AC source. Analog source to this antenna. So how the radiation will come? So we need to take some conditions. So what are the conditions we have to consider to get the radiation from this antenna? If it is antenna, it is nothing but a wire. So analog signal, AC signal is applied to this wire. Then only we have to produce radiation. How the radiation means? The source of radiation is current creation. That is the major point. The first thing is, if you want to generate the radiation, you need to create the current. how the current is created. First of all, now we are applying analog signal here. We are applying analog signal, there will be a charges. Charges means electrons. So once applying the analog signal means electrical signal or voltage, there will be a movement in the charges. There will be a movement in the charges means depends upon your analog signal means here we are applying the analog signal in lines or electrical signal in lines. Based on the voltage, there will be a change in the movement of charges. That means rate of change of velocity in the charges. That is acceleration or deacceleration in the charges. Once we get the acceleration or deacceleration in the charges, we get current. So that means to get the radiation, we need to create the current. When we get the current means, so acceleration or deacceleration in the charges, then the current is created, then radiation will be produced. So now here we are taking single wire antenna, radiation mechanism in single wire antenna. First of all, we need to create the current. So to get the creation of the current, what we have to do? We need to change the velocity of charge carriers. Means we need to observe the acceleration of the charge carriers. That is a major functionality. That is a major point. Now, so here to get the radiation, we need to follow some conditions. For example, here I am taking a wire. If wire is infinite, we are applying input here. If it is infinite means once we are applying the input, if the charges are moving towards this direction. First point. So now when we are applying the input, these charges are moving with some velocity. If it is uniform velocity, if the wire is infinite, there is no current is created. So if you want to create the current in the wire should be finite, or the wire should be bent, or wire should be bent, or wire should be curved, or wire should be truncated, and etc. So here simply the radiation of single wire means we need to create the current. When we get the current, we have to apply the inputs. Okay, once we apply the input, automatically there will be a rate of change of velocity in the charges. That means you get acceleration or deacceleration of the charges. Current created, radiation will be produced. So we have to take some conditions. Radiation will be produced, but under some conditions. What are those conditions? The wire should be finite. Even though you have uniform velocity in the charges, wire should be bent or curved or truncated, then only current is created, then only radiation will be produced. If your wire is infinite, if you have uniform velocity in the charges, there is no current created, there is no radiation is produced. That is the radiation mechanism in single wire. If you go for second case, radiation mechanism in two wire. Now here I am going to take radiation mechanism in two wire. Two-wire radiation mechanism. Here I am applying the AC signal. Two-wire radiation mechanism. Here I am going to take AC signal. It is applied to an antenna. So the part of antenna is tapered here. So the tapered antenna is connected with the help of the wire. So here we are taking two conducting wires. So these are connected to the voltage source with the help of a wire. Okay, so here I am going to take plus and minus. Now what we are applying? Analog signal. During the positive half cycle, it has one polarity, it has another polarity. Why? Because these are the two poles. Two conducting wires, two poles, one is positive pole, other one is negative pole, when we have positive half cycle. If you take negative half cycle, it becomes negative, it becomes positive. Again, if you are applying the positive, because it is continuous time signal. So positive, negative, that means interchange the polarities of the poles. So at that particular time, radiation will be produced. Once here we have the signal is passed along the cable like this. So the field lines are negative to positive, like this. So these are formula like this. The field lines are here positive, negative 2 positive, negative 2 positive, negative 2 positive, negative 2 positive, positive, etc. So once we remove some part of antenna here, if you remove some part of antenna here, the field lines are stayed in the free space like this. What symbols? Here negative, negative, positive, 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 negative, negative. So those all are attracted here, negative, positive, attracted, negative, positive, attracted, negative, positive, attracted, negative, positive, attracted. So here we have three directions. For negative to positive, positive to positive, like this. So it's looking like my EM wave or spherical wave. So this is the radiation mechanism 2.1.